edition of our book review series. Today we'll be reviewing Street Smarts by Jim Rogers. The last book we reviewed was The Long Direction by Ganesha Balikrishnan. That book was focused on a budget backpacker who is more focused on saving his money and hitchhiking. This person is a rich traveler, so he's traveling on fancy motorcycles and he's on a Mercedes-Benz car in one of his travels actually. So he actually has a lot of money that he can really enjoy his travels with. So I'm really interested to see the difference of how these people experience their travels in comparison from the amount of money they use on their travels. One thing that got me really interested about this book is how this guy, Jim Rogers, because he's an investor, how this sort of travel will play into his sort of personal life and how it will actually affect him as a person. And in the end, it actually really makes him make some big decisions in his life. I think that this book was really enjoyable. Just for you guys to be warned, this is not all travel. It's more of a biography of Jim Rogers' life. So there are also some parts about his life before he traveled and about the decisions he made in his life. So, three things that I really enjoyed about this book. First, his decisions on where to move. So before, he lived in America, in New York. But then he was thinking that he wanted to move to somewhere in Asia. So he thought of Shanghai, Beijing, Hong Kong, and Singapore. In the end, his decision is that he'll move to Singapore. Which I think is really interesting because we've had a lot of videos on Singapore and we've talked about its sort of economic greatness and how it used to be such like just a swamp and how it's grown like that. So the next chapter is Nations of Immigrants. In that chapter, he explains why he moved to Singapore. First, the good healthcare. They have a plan that if anyone ever gets sick, they'll fly right back to Singapore because there they have really quality healthcare. The education system was another reason. He has two kids, so he really wants them to have the best education possible. And also, he thinks that it's like one of the areas that's going to be economically stable for most of his children's lifetime. So he thinks that that's why he moved to Singapore. We also live in Singapore, so we also fully understand his decision, and we actually also really love Singapore ourselves. Second, the sort of backstory into what happened before he retired. So him in Oxford, him in Yale, how he started investing in Wall Street. I think that's all really interesting stuff. And even though it's not mainly travel, I think it makes you better understand the book. Because some of the finance bits I also really enjoyed because it really made my brain get thinking. So I really love this book. Jim Rogers is a really interesting person. He's so smart in the way that he does things and calculates every decision he makes in his life. And definitely, last but not least for sure, is the travel areas where he travels on a motorbike around the world, on a car around the world. I think those experiences were really interesting because he's not just going on a route where he goes through a few countries around the world. He's really traveling through Western Europe, he goes through Central America, I think on his motorbike route. That was one of the travels he set actually a Guinness World Record on because he was actually slightly more than a year just on his motorbike traveling around the world. So I think it's really amazing the trip he did. It also influenced him in quite a lot of different ways. He was able to look at some of the countries, you know, and it also helped him as an investor. He could see how some of the countries were doing, if he should invest in them. And I think that it was a really interesting travel, because by this time he'd already retired and he's just enjoying his life. So I think that it was really quite interesting to see how this sort of motorcycle travel affects the rest and the later chapters of this book. So overall, I think that this was a really interesting book to read. I think it's a bit different from the usual type of books you're reading. I'm really enjoying this book review series right now and seeing the different types of books that we've been reviewing. So I hope you all enjoyed this video. Maybe you guys will also get a chance to read this book yourself. Thank you for watching and see you at my next destination.